Hi, everybody.
Wait, we're live?
Oh, yeah, we're the liveliest bunch.
Dude, I was just chilling, man. Welcome back. Week one, here is my simple story. I had a deafened end muted, so I didn't hear you talking. Whoops. I'm good at this. I know what I'm doing.
You are good at this. Yeah, it's our first day back. It's all good. We're afforded these inconsistencies.
Yeah. My name is Lauren. I'm joined by the Fox of Fox, Kitchen Native Heroes, Community Coach, Neighborhood Friendly, Colin Walker.
Hey, guys.
We have had a whale of a time casting these games tonight, and we are going to be moving forward. We saw Firm Handshake looking pretty good up until they ran to that Diablo Diva composition from 101st Northumberland Fusiliers.
I just watched that clip again because Russ put it on Twitter, and holy mole's feet. That diva combo. Actually disgusting.
Mole's feet?
Yeah, or holy moly, whatever you want to call it. I don't know. I'm weird.
No. Can't change it now. It's too late.
Actually intense, though.
But this is going to be an interesting matchup. The reason why I say this, and let's see if we can hear from our good old-fashioned. Is this the best three? Have we made it to the finals?
Can confirm.
We have made it to the finals, week one, HeroSype Temple Storm series. So this will be a best of three affair. These teams will have a chance to play each other at least twice. And it's going to be a good one because 101st Northumberland Fusiliers has members that won season one against the new guys. And they find themselves up against the team that took them down last season. The bitter rivalry could be starting right here. Dude, I'm looking back. Wow, I'm like just chilling right then. I had no idea. I'm just like straight in my shirt. Like I'm just.
I love it. Oh. I'm just like sitting there, just like lulling.
Feels good, man. Feels good. But yeah, I'm excited to see this because if I'm the new guys, it's like when they first started, week one last season, They were like we had been together for like 2 days.
Yeah,
and we were really impressed with how they did, and they made it to the final. So I'm glad to see that they stuck together. So now they have some experience under their belt. They've seen some really stiff competition in this series, and they're going to go up against exactly it again. Curious to see how they've evolved.
I am too, man. I am too. Like, Firm Handshake has been playing really well. Wait, sorry. No, we just watched Firm Handshake versus 101st. 101st versus the new guys, right? That's what it is?
Yeah.
Yeah, so 101st played really well into a comp that I don't think they should have beaten. Like, I really don't. I'm pretty sure that, the Diablo-Brightwing combo wasn't the hottest, but, man, they made it work. They had Devil's Due with Diablo. You know, he was basically healing himself. And do you remember when those fights were coming out? And I was like, I'm not sure if they can be diving Diablo and looking to kill him in these, just because they can't do it fast enough, right? Like they can't be just diving the front line and trying to kill it. They definitely need to be looking at diving the back line. And that's what we found. Like, do you remember that one fight where Jin sat at, like, 5% health for, like, 10 minutes?
How did I forget?
Like, 20 minutes, like, he was just, like, picking up globes and picking up globes. Like, just, like, you know, just, like, just dips in the lane, grabs a globe, now he's half health again, and it's, like, you know, one Brightwing heal comes in, and then he's half health, and it's, like, they just weren't able to kill him, and then the rest of the backline of their team were able to just go in and get the kills that they needed, so, and, man, that combination. I can't even right. Talk enough about that combo, dude.
Dude, have you seen Stranger Things?
Yes.
It was the Sergeant Hopper. It was the one punch. Nice. It only needed to happen one time. If you watch Stranger Things season one, I swear to you, throughout the entire season, he only had to punch somebody one time. They were out every time.
True. What it's like got? One Punch Man. Nope. Have you watched One Punch Man?
I have.
It's so freaking awesome.
They were like, we only need this wombo to happen the one time. But when it does, woo-wee! As Kyle would say. Jorge got banned out. We've heard from our good old-fashioned Argy. Braxis was the first ban. You know, Khalid.
I don't think they really make them like that anymore. Man. I'll tell you, don't I just
make them like that anymore. What a classy guy.
Hey, question to you and viewers. Why do people ban Warhead so often? Like, what's up with that? Why do you think these teams don't like Warhead?
You know, on its surface, I'm not the hugest fan of that map. It's huge. It invites a good amount of cheese, potentially. But the more I've played it, the more I've come to enjoy it.
Yeah.
And I don't think it's as bad as some people. I think it's just like a knee-jerk reaction. It's like, oh, it's a new map. It's big. It's kind of like...
Yeah.
It has a different tempo.
Yeah.
As you would. But I don't know. I like it. I like it now. I can live with it. But we are going to be going to Battlefield of Eternity for the first game in this best of three.
Yes.
And that was actually the last battleground these two teams played each other on. And if you remember, we interviewed Talion after his, like, frontline Jaina saved the day.
Oh, yeah, that. Dude, that was intense.
Oh, yeah. So I'm sure they remember all that on both sides of the aisle. So once we get in this lobby, sparks are going to fly.
I did say earlier I really wanted to see BOE come out, so I'm stoked that that happened. Do we know which team picked BOE, I wonder? Okay, so 101st ran on. 101st picked BOE. So that means they're going to be second pick. I wonder what's... I wonder if, like, either of these teams, especially 101st, has something specific planned out for this map.
I mean, Talion said when they brought up Jaina at the finals, it wasn't exactly the most planned thing in the world. It's the impression that I got. But they do have plenty of options available to their hero pool.
Yeah.
Just saw them pull off some pretty interesting shenanigans on paper. I don't think that's a game they should have won. And yet here they are demonstrating their prowess. We're getting in the lobby now. Phoenix, friend of mine. Hold on, looks like One Punch Man.
Dude, I was just reading that and laughing. I was going to, like, tell you, but I was like, I hope you read it. Okay, you want to know what's funny? Last season, do you remember? I'm pretty sure that you said it. Yeah, actually, you definitely said it. It wasn't me. A big combo came out from Santa, and you're like, Santa Claus is coming to town or something.
Yeah, I remember that.
So good, dude. Oh, wait, here's another comment about...
We never banned Warhead.
Yay, LZ Gamer, I love you. Thank you for not banning Warhead. Warhead is too big. No.
Nah.
Big mess feel like they have smaller margin for error. Interesting.
We demand Caddis fact. Well, yeah, my cat's been strolling around here all night. Whenever I sit here, they suddenly show up. You know,
I love cats, dude. Wait, your cat's on stream?
They were, apparently.
I want a cat so bad, but at the same time, I don't, you know?
I know.
I'm so scared to get animals because, traveling and stuff. And
they're nuts, man.
Yeah.
My cats are psychopaths. Dude, my sister had to put up these cats for, like, 7 weeks when I went to California for Heroes of the Dorm.
Oh, yeah, because you're a popular, like, real stream or caster. Like, that's insane. That's so cool. What's it like being in California? Why are you so awesome?
I had a lot of fun out. California. I went back out there in a heartbeat, man. Loved it. I want to try to move out there, but yeah. My sister, she had to show up here like every other day for like 7.5 weeks. Ooh, well.
Honestly, sister MVP. That's
the
busted.
Fans want to see a cat. Help, please. I can't. I don't feel like going after him. Jin came in the lobby. I guess we were waiting for, I don't know, maybe his computer restarted or something, but we're all in here now. So we saw some oddball shenanigans last game, I would say.
Yeah.
The double D, the Panseer combination, all that was out there.
True. And this is another map for D.Va, though. So I say this is one of her best maps. This and Shrines. It's funny how I said D.Va was good on Shrines, and then she shows up, and then we see here. That's like the exact situation why she's good on Shrines, because, mm-hmm. you know, you force your opponents into there. Sometimes you can have a Tyrael on the backside, holy grounding your opponents into the Shrine, and the bomb comes out, and it's like, What do we do, guys? So, yeah, stuff like that. And yeah, she's also great on this map.
Yeah.
So I would expect to see very similar bans. So, you know, the Anubarak, the Dahaka, the Uther. Preferably the Uther over Dahaka, though, but we'll have to see.
Yeah, apparently Robot has some commentary to add about the draft as well. But over on the right side, I do believe it is the new guy. And we'll see 101st Northumberland Fusiliers on the left. You guys enjoy the luxury of first pick, first ban. And it's a curious thing to see in the meta that it's so strong that even on a map like Battle for the Paternity, which has normally inspired a shift in priority in the draft, still normally see those same mainstays in the first ban rotation. But you guys showing something different, looking to take Li Ming off. No, we're going to see a new Brack ban yet again. There your first pick in you, man. Interesting.
The new guy's your first pick, right? Yeah.
Is this the Uther first pick?
It might be. Yeah. Pretty standard. And it just like opens you up for so much good stuff. I would like to see higher gray main prioritization on this map, just because we've only seen one gray main, right, so far?
Yep.
Yeah.
Bow Wow. Malfurion along with Stitches.
101st taking notes from Dignitas here, apparently.
Yeah.
Mal Stitches one too. Very interesting. You know, Stitches is good on this map just because there's so much time where teams just like posture against each other, and it's usually pretty easy to know where your opponents are. So Stitches is great on this map for that reason.
Yeah.
But, you know, Stitches in the 1-2. I'm not sure if they needed to do it, but they did do it. So 101st showing that they want to play that that hook combo to try to get some kills off the new guys.
I like to use the phrase getting called to the carpet. The hook into the root, because like you just get yanked right onto the Malfurion root and you just
called to the carpet. Dude, how do you do this?
I do what?
How do you just like come up with something great for everything? Getting called to the carpet.
I mean, I feel it's an apt description. That's what happens, right? It feels bad.
It does.
2-3 yeah. Selection, see the new guys. Having some pretty difficult choices to make, and they are going to prioritize Li Ming.
And there's the
definitely
Dahaka.
A strong hero. And then
I like that.
Dahaka shows up.
Okay, sweet. So with Mouth's changes now, his new root at 7 reduces healing from any heroes caught in it by 30%. Is it? So that's actually disgusting. With like Stitch's Mouth, you know, you hook in a target and they have reduced healing. It's pretty gnarly, man.
Yeah. Gnarly is a good word for it. Li Ming offer a ton of poke. Definitely put pressure on during the immortal phase if left to their own devices. Also has a good amount of mobility, so if they do get yanked by a Stitch's hook, they could be crafty enough to teleport away to safety in time. The Uther pick also is pretty strong against Stitches, because if you go for the Guardian of the Ancient Kings, which I would say is a standard at level 7 these days, anybody getting a hook could have 75 armor. It's going to be pretty tough to take that down.
Murden Bando, that's an interesting one. I guess just, you know, in general, he's good on this map. You know, if he's going the stacked Q talent, you can get a lot of damage onto the Immortals. And also, he's pretty good, you know, frontline target. And he's difficult, or sorry, he's not the best frontline target for Stitches to hook, because if the Mouth doesn't respond immediately and get him in the root, Murden's just jumping away. The Gray Main Band coming out, I guess they just don't want 101st to pick it up here in that 3-4 on this rotation. Pretty good pick, pretty good ban. So,
yeah,
what's 101st going for here? Are they just gonna like pick up the Vala? Are they looking at maybe something like a Kael Thas to complement the hook combination from Stitches? Like, what do you think we'll see?
I think you want a damage dealer, and I think you want to secure your solo lane. You're gonna be going up against Dahaka, so you want to try to make sure you shore that up, see what cards are on the table for the new guys, and use that last slot to try to make a response to that. I mean, you already have your support. You have your main tank sorts and Stitches. You need a solo laner. I think Vala would be really strong here.
Tassadar's still up. Like, that would be really good as well. Tass Vala works really well into Uther because, you know, neither of them have that hard CC and they're good in those long fights, something that Uther is, you know, not very strong with. So, you know, we could see something like that come out. And then, like I said, there's, you know, the option of having... Okay, so Lunara, Arthas... It's pretty good. Lunara is really strong into Uther for the exact same reason that I just stated. And then Arthas is, you know, he's just a menace. This Dahaka digs in. It's going to be really difficult for Dahaka to move around, get much done because of these slows from Arthas. The double tank coming out. So now, do you think we're going to see the new guys respond with something like Tychus?
I think they could definitely do worse. I mean, they already have their ability-based damage in Li Ming. Some range auto attack damage never hurts. And in this situation, you're looking down two warriors who have no mobility whatsoever. I would strongly consider going Tychus here. The only other person I'd consider is Greymane, but wait, I already banned them out.
The so. Bandago doesn't exist. So, yeah. We've got the global covered, so it's now just another warrior plus a ranged damage dealer, or perhaps a melee, but I would definitely, you know, I definitely see that the Tychus plus another warrior coming out here. Diablo is up as well. So we'll just have to see what this team decides to do.
I like the idea of Diablo here, and so do the new guys.
Wow. Diablo Tychus it is, man. It's like we're prophets or whatever.
It's almost like we know what the heck we're talking about there.
101st. Now what is this like? I keep saying the Tassadar, but I'm not.
I don't know. I think you can force wall Tassadar.
Yeah, like I think that would be really good too, but I'm not 100% sold on it. It works pretty well with the Lunara, but nowhere near as well as if that Lunara were a Vala. So perhaps just a mage then, right? Like,
I mean, if you're trying to go Michael Jackson's off the wall, you can go Lily. Think about it.
I don't even know what that means, man, but I love it. Yeah, that's true. Are they just going to send Arthas up there? Okay, that's actually pretty sweet. I was going to say, they need something to satisfy the solo lane requirement, unless they just throw the Arthas up there, which is perfectly viable. But the Thrall, okay, I like that.
I think you send Arthas to the solo lane. I think you can add more kill pressure with Thrall.
Yeah.
Stitches lands a hook, call it a carpet, throw down a Malfurion root, makes it point and click simple for Thrall to have his follow-up root, and that should be all the time in the world for Lunara and Thrall to secure a takedown on pretty much anybody. Curious to see how this shakes out, though. Uther's going to have some real micromanagement to consider. He has some long cooldowns. He's going up against Lunara, has a ton of sustained damage.
As well as split damage, too, right?
Yeah. Like,
as
soon as she Splintered gets Spirit here. 7, yeah. I would imagine we would see that.
On top of the bouncing Qs from Thrall. And as well, I would like to compliment what you said. Put Arthas in that solo lane and get Q stack talent for Thrall. Put him in that format. Man, he's going to be stacking that thing up like crazy. I actually really like the Thrall pick. I'm not sure how good he is right now with the changes because I haven't got to flirt with him a lot. But Thrall. Ooh, no, but like, yeah, I want to see how he works because this is actually the situation that I thought Thrall would be most effective in when I was like theory crafting him. But yeah, we'll have to see, especially considering how they're up against Uther. You know, Uther's really good against like single target burst, but with that Lunara and Thrall, they're going to be spreading damage across multiple targets. Yeah. So.
And Thrall hits like a real boy these days. I know you've been out in Sweden, but he does it to you for real. But here we go. First week, Heroes Hype, Temple Storm Series Season 2. This is the finals. Best of three over on the left side. We have 101st North. Oh, is this the first time I drop it? Oh, no. Wait, what is it? 101st Northumberland Fusiliers. It's going to be Slice Blade on Thrall. Elheim's on Malfurion. Kante is playing Lunara. LZ seconds. Gamer on Arthas. And Jin will round it out on Stitches.
And on the right in red is the new guys. We got Stu Manchu playing Diablo, Phoenix on Uther, Santa Claus playing Dahaka, Ataro on Li Ming, and Grimm playing the Tychus.
Curious to see how they commit the lanes. We're actually going to see Slice Blade on Thrall go up to the top by their onesie. So the Q stacking.
Not happening.
Stands to be a bit diminished, I would say. It goes for Rolling Thunder at level 1.
All right, that's fine. It's a little bit of a different play style, but the kill pressure for 101st, not really going to be there. And it looks like Lunara is heading up top. Are they just going to do this 2-3 and just completely ignore this laning phase?
It would be interesting. I mean, we've seen some out-of-the-box play from 101st Northumberland Fusiliers. The new guys are definitely going to be mindful and watch their P's and Q's, see what the heck they have up their sleeve.
Honestly, that's really smart. Like, that's super smart, because giving that, especially considering what talent they went with the Thrall, the fact that, oh, the Grim gets hit by the hook, but you know, not quite enough to kill him here. LZ Gamer actually pushing up with the Arthas and Jhin looking to get that last slam, and they do get the kill onto Tychus. So, 101st showing up in this laning phase here to learn.
Jhin slams the gabble, gets the first takedown. I mean, the 2-3 split has paid off. It forced out a response. The hook goes into the root. Alheim was hearthing back, decides to stick around. It's one last heal in. It forced a response. Leeming at the rotate up towards the top. That takes damage away from the bottom lane. And the unorthodox setup helping them out early on.
Yeah, I definitely like the way that they're setting up their lanes here. See these sprays coming down, just the pleb and hexagon. Yeah, whatever.
No thumbs up.
Yeah. Dude, that's my favorite one. Is that the one you use?
Yeah, of course. Hello?
Nobody else uses it. Bless Dude. You, man.
The boons. The roof goes in from Grim. On Grim, he starts to back away. Jin's looking for a hook target, but there's no follow-up. So he's just going to be all right. First Immortal shows up. LZ Gamer emerges from the bush and knocks Ataru down to 40% health or less. I wasn't expecting all that burst damage.
Yeah, me either. And Picante just walking up, getting a little bit of damage onto these Immortals. And I think that's pretty much going to be the story of this phase here. You know, 101st are probably just going to be looking for the hook plus root, just like that. This one does miss, but... And then off that chunk damage, just move into Lunara. Get a little bit of damage onto the Immortals. But at the same time, the new guys definitely have the composition to deal with that. They just send Dehaka down to the side lane. And now, look at this. 101st losing four minions on the bottom side, but they do respond, you know, timely enough, and they send Thrall to this top side.
Yeah, the Dehaka pickup for the new guys definitely makes these longer progression Immortal phases somewhat interesting for 101st Northumberland Fusiliers. That buys time for Dehaka with that
sand.
It shows up globally, but even with that, we still see 101st in experience. Oh, oh, goes in and Lee Ming gets erased.
And the fight is not over. LZ Gamer is pushing in with the slows from Arthas, and Stu Manchu is taking so much damage via overpower there onto Picante, but not enough. And actually, Elheim getting caught a little bit here. And there's the root as well into the carpet, as you said. And Phoenix is taking a massive amount of damage, and he goes down as well. That's two picks over for 101st, and they are showing up in this early game.
Kala, no joke, that might almost inspire a clean selection at level 7, because this chain root is deadly.
Yeah, that's awful.
They're gonna need that 75 armor or a perfectly timed cleanse, or just watch out for these hits, because whenever Jhin goes fishing, he yanked Li Ming out there, and you just take your hands off keyboard at that point. That burst damage is serious.
And we're seeing the value from that Murden ban show up too, because, you know, if Murden got hooked in some of these situations, if he didn't root immediately, Murden just jumps out. But, you know, if you land the hook onto Diablo or Dehaka, like, Dehaka can burrow, but as soon as he comes out, he's on that carpet again, as you would say. Like, the warrior pickups for the new guys are going to have a difficult time with the combination of hook plus root from 101st.
Seeing all that, I mean, Stitches falls out of the meta for a while, but he never actually gets worse. It's just like people will start to remember, oh, yanking people out of position has value. And you see that paving the way for the first Immortal to get picked up by 101st Northumberland Fusiliers. The 51 tower, a little bit of shield left still on the Immortal. They should be able to get both of these towers, and I don't think they need to hang around too much after that.
They've got the level 7, so the new guys have to be careful of a hard engage here from 101st. They are positioning up. They do have the hook plus root, and you know, the only range damage for the new guys is basically on this Li Ming. Tychus can't come up any further, so 101st do decide to back off, and there's actually the root, but a little bit of a disconnect. Elheim wasn't there for the root to follow up on that hook. Sorry, tiny bit of a communication mismatch there. That would have been massive.
I agree. Like, I'm sure their voice comms, is like the call was to retreat, and then Jhin just saw an opportunity, but the rest of the team wasn't there. So no follow-up, another hook goes out, no follow-up root from Malfurion or Arthas. Arthas throws down a root, just misses Grim. A little bit of poke damage in from Picante's Lunara. They need to get to level 6, though, before new guys want to try to make any aggressive gesture.
Wait, Jin's just, like, so good. Like, okay, hold on. After this, like, this is insane. There's the hook into a root. The follow-up damage onto Tychus. Tychus is just standing there. He knows he's dead. But Jhin is actually so good. Did you see what he just did there? He shows on the minion wave, and then he walked up just like that. Gave a little bit of vision showing him walking up, and then he immediately mounts up and goes bottom. Like, so the new guys think that he rotates into the top bush, but he just walks into this bottom bush, lands a free hook, gets another kill. Like, this guy's a really smart warrior player. Like, I haven't seen any players in the amateur scene mess with vision like this guy does. Like, insane. Like, I'm so stoked on this player.
I'm telling you, man, once I start looking for a coach, man, I'm learning how to get better at tanks. Jin's a strong candidate for all that. I mean, that was just sensational play. It's micro decisions like that that can have a huge impact, because once again, we saw member of the new guys with the hugest frowny face you've ever seen.
Yep.
Seeing rooted over their name for 8 years. Feels bad.
Oh, and Santa Claus, he uses his burrow and he's going to fall down too. Like, and yeah, I love how he did exactly what I was talking about as I was talking about it, because like the communication from the new guys had to be, okay, you know, Stitches is probably going up now, like be careful top, because he goes missing and he's showing on the wave that he's walking top. And then immediately this hook comes out from the bottom side. Actually, as we say this, Diablo lands the combination onto the Thrall, and that's dead green Jesus. But yeah, sorry, I'm just so stoked on Jin's play. I can't stop talking about it.
Oh, I'm right there with you, man. Stu Manchu shadow charges in on LZ Gamer, the overpower, but he's able to wrap around a corner, throws down the root for his own disengage. Grim catches the hook, no follow-up. Conte rotates up. They're so close to level 10, I'm surprised they're actually being this far forward and aggressive with Thrall not here in the equation, but it's not stopping him at all.
Yep, 10's coming in for 101st. We do see the Earthquake as well, so when you get those hooks into Earthquakes, man, it is going to be difficult to get anywhere as the new guys. Leaping Strike as well, and everything else pretty standard. There's the hook into... Oh, I don't really have time to say it. The hook into Dead.
I mean, the moment that hook comes out, it's just like, tell my story, guys.
The time it was a hook into a bot or into, like, an immortal stun, like, or yeah, insane.
The mouth root was already on the ground before Li Ming even got hooked back. I don't even know if you need Earthquake if you're landing hooks and you have a follow up like this. Like, it's actually disgusting.
Guys. Wait, I'm with you on that. Imagine the Sundering, and then it's basically like a smorgasbord for Jin. It's like you sunder, you split, and it's like, which target shall I hook him and instantly kill? The root is there because there's no way this Stitches player misses onto a immobile target, so I actually think Sundering would have been pretty good.
Yeah, I mean, the Earthquake is just for spice flavor at this point.
Yeah.
I just doesn't seem necessary, the technical ability on
display. However, it does really help out onto Picante if he gets dove. Because, you know, you drop that Earthquake and Lunar is able to Leaping Strike and, you know, basically kite her opponents extremely well. So, especially considering how there's no cleanse. So, it is the safer pick, but, man, I would have loved to see the Sunray. I'm 100% with you on that one.
Oh, yeah, the enthusiast in me that loves seeing crazy team fights always likes to see a Sundering, but cooler heads do prevail. Earthquake is the selection. Good amount of health left on this immortal. You see LZ Gamer on the flank looking to see if there's going to be any surprise shenanigans that wasn't meant to be, though. Level 13, not too far off. They might look to push through this bottom wall if they can catch somebody with a hook after that. Hook just barely misses, but the Malfurion root was there. They were looking for it.
Yeah, and this Immortal's looking really healthy. The root goes out, and really nice blink there from Ataro, not getting caught out by the Howling Blast, and Thrall actually soloing to Haka. He forces out the Burrow and gets that Earthquake on top, and now the team fight engages. Stu Manchu just land the Apocalypse onto two targets, but it is not enough. The Leaping Strike comes out, and Tychus goes down.
A gruesome Twilight Dream takes all the starch out of the potential engagement from the new guys. The bottom keep is going to get claimed. As a result, LZ Gamer gets isolated for the moment. Malfurion hits the root. The hook brings Fu Manchu back, finds himself a long way from home. Li Ming trying to do what he can for the orbs. The Divine Shield from Phoenix is going to save Diablo. Lives to fight another day, but the damage is done, Kyle. Bottom keep is claimed. 3-level lead. It's tough.
Man, that's rough. 101st are just going to be able to stack the top side of this map now forever, because Dahaka has to stay down there to de-push these catapult minions that are going to be pushing in. And this is going to be really difficult for the new guys to deal with. Jin just posturing up, looking with the rest of his team to try to grab one of these hooks, and the new guys not showing anyone. They actually just completely walk on the other side of the minion wave. So 101st has no idea where the new guys are right now. You know, they can speculate, but...
And I mean, look at this aggressive positioning from Jin and the members of 101st Northumberland. They were hoping to see somebody rotate across the middle, but here we go.
Watch the hook, it's gonna come in.
Jin's looking to go fishing. Oh! catches Grimm.
Oh, they just caught vision of Li Ming. They know where she is now. They're just gonna hunt her down. She's dead. 100%.
Uh-oh. The chase is on Li Ming. She teleports. Gets the hearth.
Yeah, dude, this player has such good game sense. Like, I gotta stop pumping his tires or else no hats are ever gonna fit him in the world just because I'm boosting his ego. But man, this player is actually really good.
The blind hook, just the Sherlock Holmes fish and tackle. I mean, these folks, man, good lord. Diablo's gonna get taken down as well. Picante, you have another leaping strike to jump on the Grimm, so maybe not. But I mean, to do the detective work, to look around at all the variables and be like, I think Li Ming's right there. And then to land it right as they're trying to hearth, that is disheartening if you catch the receiver in the one of those.
Funny thing is Jin had to decide, like, yo, am I going to hook the bush or am I gonna hook this open space? She's in one of two, and he's like, it's easier for me to guess the bush, so I'm assuming she's the better player and goes and hides here, and he assumed correctly. There's another one, but the team's not ready for it. Elheim on the backside just has to walk away because of the stuns, so 15-13. This is the last fight for the new guys before this game gets out of control.
Dude, nobody's ready for these hooks. No one on the side of new guys, so you need to contact them to use lethal strike to their advantage to get out of there, but low health bars on the side of 101st Motion. Umbreling Fusiliers, we see the burrow, the root goes in with the lowered armor, followed up with the Twilight Dream. This could be a huge team fight in favor of 101st. Two Manchu trying to get the takedown on Picante, who has 7 health.
Survived with 7 HP. Wow.
That's insane.
That is insane. And now this next Immortal is going to be 100% pushing just at the keep in the top side. This looks like it's spelling the end of the game here, Haloran. 101st really showing up, and you know, that was 15-13, like I said, the last fight that the new guys were going to get. But we also saw that exact situation that I was talking about earlier. They had 4 people dive onto Picante. Picante was, you know, pretty far forward on the Lunara. But then we saw the Leaping Strike and then the Earthquake go out, and nobody could get onto the Lunara with that Earthquake in the ground. So I really liked that interaction and the way that 101st played that team fight. So full health Immortal on the top side. Man, do you think this is the end of the game?
I think it's going to be pretty difficult for the new guys to make it sure that anything else happens. Grimm's getting isolated into the root. Use the running gun, jumps into the root. That feels bad. Tychus gets banished off the next. Manchu, the next target, gets slowed down. Slice Blade applying pressure. The panic apocalypse is not going to be enough. The nice root follow-up. I mean, right now, 101st Northumberland Fusiliers are running shot.
Yeah, it's going to be really difficult for Li Ming to get this Immortal health down, but I'm not sure if it's gonna happen. The Earthquake comes out and the dive is happening. Phoenix taking a massive amount of damage. Both of these frontline targets just chunking down into the Uther, and you know, Dahaka walking on the backside just trying to salvage the situation. Not happening. Drill comes out for Grimm, but the situation is looking synonymous to his name.
Top well played. The top key falls, plenty of shielding left on this Immortal. The hook goes out. We've seen it time and time again by now. A hook is certain death. You're up against Jin Stitches. Another takedown. 20-1. I'd point out as the core goes down to 50% and falling, and the rest seems like a foregone conclusion, Kyler. Game one goes over to 101st Northumberland Fusiliers.
Thinking emoji. That opens up the draft for sure if this is a series.
The draft's the Autobahn at that point. I mean, I don't think you have any choice but to ban Stitches.
Wait, are you looking at the stats on this Thrall? Holy cow, does he do a lot of damage now?
Kyle, do you remember at the beginning of this game, I said Thrall hits like a real boy.
Well, I did hear that. I thought you were trolling, but...
Well, now you see it.
For 10 seconds, I'm
trying. Dude, yeah, it looked like Lunara was chunking people. But no, it was Thrall.
So Magnetite at 4 is actually good. I was thinking about this talent.
Thrall is crazy.
Hold on. Ancestral Wrath. Magnetite, yeah, with the Earthquake there. That's actually crazy. You, like, never... Ooh, wow, that's actually insane.
It's take Take notes, kids.
Yeah, man, I'm actually going to go give that a shot. I love Thrall, and he's so good in Hero League because he's, you know, one of those heroes that does a lot of damage plus has high sustain, so.
Thrall's one of my favorite heroes, and since the rework, Exhibit A. I mean, I was wondering where some of those health bars were going because it was just like, where's Grayman at? Because it looks like 40% of someone's health just went away. Like, curse a bullet? No.
Dude, it's pretty spooky, let me be honest.
Pretty spooky. Dude, I'm telling you, how many times did we see someone get hooked by Jhin and before the word rooted was gone over their head, they were gone.
Oh no, straight up, like there was times where Li Ming didn't even get rooted. Like that. Like, I'm not even joking, there was actually that, maybe like not the, times, the, but there was a time where Li Ming got hooked and died on impact.
Right.
Like, Dignitas did the same thing when they had Li Ming.
75 armor.
Yeah, that's scary.
Orasku said, anybody count many times Lawrence said first Northumberland Fusiliers? I think I've only not said it once. Who died? The new guys found out that Stitches is a hero and that Thrall does hero damage. So, 101st Northumberland Fusiliers go up 1-0 in his best of three. This is week one. Temple Storm Heroes hype series. And this is just the beginning, man. This is the first week.
I'm stoked for all this to play out and see how these drafts change, see if any of these teams change up. But man, 101st looking real hot. What do you think? Like, man, I like their roster. I like the way that they're playing. I like the fact that they draft different stuff. Like, we only saw them play two of the same comps, right, so far?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, it's interesting because 101st Northumberland players are largely four guys in a legend from last season who won season one.
Yep.
So it's always something interesting to see when you have a new player get brought into the fold. You have, you know, a team that has as much history as this team does, or, you know, as much experience playing together, bringing a new dynamic. You always wonder, you know, how does that synergy mesh in? And it seems to be working pretty well.
Yeah, for sure.
Picante has been making plays. The well-timed leaping strikes, both offensively and defensively, really speaks to his ability as a player. I think he's a fine addition to this team. If I'm on the side of the new guys, I won ban Stitches, and then I forget that game even happened. Because
That's important.
A lot of that really came off the Stitches hooks. Jhin's hooks were just insane. It's hard to even gauge like how well you did as a team because it was just like, we're getting taken out of position and then delete. Like,
yeah.
So if you're going to have a hope for game three, it's just like, hey, you know, they just got us with Stitches hooks. We take that off the board. We treat this like game one. We don't let that sink in. We don't let that get us down. We earned our, like, we got here. We didn't just, you know, traipse our way in. We know how to play the game.
Yep.
It's a new game.
And I said this in the beginning of the draft. Like, I don't understand the relative strength of a lot of the heroes that got changed. You know, like Malfurion, I'm not sure where he sits in the draft anymore, or even just as a pick. Thrall, and I definitely don't know where he sits in the draft or even as a general pick right now. But, you know, watching that game, like, that Thrall crushed the damage, and you know, it's not like Thrall was weak with damage before. It's just, you know, his kit was very linear, and it just didn't work very well in the meta. But I can see him actually coming out, you're coming back pretty well actually with those changes. I haven't spent a lot of time looking at his talents or anything like that, because obviously being at mid-season Brawl, I have to focus on current patch and not waste time looking at other stuff. But yeah, man, like, that's pretty darn cool. I really liked seeing that, especially considering how much I love that hero. I wonder if we'll see any... Like, what were the other changes that went through that were pretty massive? It was pretty much just those two that were actually substantial.
Well, the thing that's really interesting about... The interesting about Thrall is that in team fights, when there's so many different abilities and things going on, it's easy for him to fly under the radar. It's like, you're not always looking out for the feral lunge route, or whatever it's called. You're not always looking out for his damage. Like, he just has this attack animation. He just bonks you on the head. It's not like, you know, a magic missile. It's not an orb from Li Ming. So when someone that has these, you know, non-jazz hands, you know, just utilitarian damage, he's topping the charts. It's very easy to be like, where'd my hope bargain?
Yeah, yeah. And he trades so well with heroes because of Frostwolf resilience, right? Like, you know, you can basically land all your skill shots on Thrall and it just doesn't matter because he's just going to out-trade you every time. Yeah.
So it's really cool to see.